Okay, so if you're using Google Sheets, you may have a table of data and you want to delete different rows based on whether or not it has certain words or certain numbers, maybe even certain dates. We're going to go through two good ways to do that and explain the differences in the different techniques. The first way is to apply a filter. So I'm going to select the data by left-clicking my mouse and just dragging to the bottom of it. That just makes it obvious to Google Sheets what you want to filter. You don't need to do that if it's all continuous data, but if you have something off to the side or maybe down to the bottom that you don't want to have filtered, just select exactly what you want to be careful about it. Go to Data and do Create a Filter. Now, after I've done that, you see that these buttons appear at the top of each one of the columns. I did select the headers as part of my data, so it's appearing up at the headers. Now you'll see the flexibility of the filter function here. Let's say we want to include Central and South and exclude West. There's several different ways to do this. Because this is pretty straightforward, we can just do it with the check marks. We can uncheck West, click OK, it goes away. And if that's all you want to do, then you're done. But so often there's more flexibility that you need. So let's go through some of the other things happening here. Another way to do that would be to filter by a condition. In this case, you want the condition to be that it does not contain, so text does not contain, West. Click OK. The output is the same. But you could also do this as text does contain, or is empty, is not empty, etc. So there's a lot of flexibility just in these menu options. Now to show you the other way, we're going to take this filter off. Just go to Data and turn off Filter. And over to the right, what we're going to do is dynamically create a new table with a certain conditions that you want to specify. We're going to do this with the filter function, so type equals and filter. And then once I hit the opening parentheses, I'm going to get this helper text that comes down here and tries to tell me what to do. And first it's reminding me I need a range. So you need to tell me what data I'm going to be working with. So let's give it this range, the same range that we gave the menu function of the filter. And the condition is that we want this filter function to return every row in here except when the value in column B is West, right? So we're going to say the condition is when something in the range of B1 to B17 is not equal to, so that's is less than or greater than. And then I'm going to put quotes around this, and that's telling Google Sheets that this is a string and not a number, West. And that's all. So this function can take multiple ranges and multiple conditions. So it can be very flexible, but this is just to show you basically how it works. So let's close this off with the ending parentheses and hit Enter. And there it goes. So it returns everything that is not in the region of West. I applied this formatting earlier, so it would usually come through as unformatted text, so ignore that part. But what is happening here is if I double click in F1, which is where I typed in the formula, it's still there. And if I click in F2, this text is here, but if I change it, Google Sheets doesn't like that because it's saying, whoa, that's actually a value that I return from the function in F1. If you change that, it doesn't make sense because it's coming from somewhere else. So let's undo that change. So if I go over here and I change this number to a 5, this updated dynamically. So the filter function right now is buying you a few things. One, it is off to the side. So if you don't want to filter this because you want to show all the data, well, you can just create a new list with the filter function. You could even choose to put this on another worksheet and then control the permissions down here if it's a multiple user worksheet in the protect sheet, but that's a whole different subject. I'll link to that in a card if you want to see it. If you want to change this, just change the values in the formula. If you want to make this future proof, so if you add something to the bottom of this table, you want this list to just pick it up automatically, you'd have to change these references. So you could say A1 to, you could just do D100, or you could just say to D, that would pick everything up, and B1 to B, we'll hit enter, still works. And if you add something to the bottom, let's just add this one again, because it's central, it will show up. If it was west, it wouldn't. Let's go down. There it goes. And the last thing, if you want this list to not change, if you want it to be static, you could just right click, left click on copy, right click again and paste. There we go. Values only. Now, if you double click in cell F1, it's just the text. That function is gone. If I were to change this now, this would not change. So I hope that was helpful. If you like that, you might just enjoy some other short videos about how to solve practical problems. Oh, I just caught that the ship dates aren't formatted anymore. Let's make that look nice before we close out this video. Paste that formatting. Ah, that's much better. Now we can say, if you like that video, you can check out a lot of other videos like it. I threw up a playlist on the right-hand corner here about other short little fixes for Google Sheets to help you work faster throughout your day. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe if you want to see more videos just like this.